एंड वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल लर्न विद निखिल। सो हियर वी हैव टेकन एन सम ऑन प्रोजेक्शन ऑफ प्लेन्स। द क्वेश्चन सेज रेक्टेंगल 30 mm एंड 50 mm साइड्स इज रेस्टिंग ऑन अ हॉरिजॉन्टल प्लेन। ऑन वन स्मॉल साइड विच इज एट 30 degree इंक्लाइंड टू वर्टिकल प्लेन। सो वी हैव अ रेक्टेंगल ऑफ साइड 30 mm एंड 50 mm। इट्स वन एंड स्मॉलर एंड इज रेस्टिंग विथ एन एंगल ऑफ 30 degree। While the surface of the plane makes at 45 degree inclination with the horizontal plane, draw its projection. So it's one of the most simplest sum on projection of planes. First step, we'll draw the horizontal xy axis. Now we'll draw a rectangle with side 30 mm and 50 mm, as one of its side is resting on horizontal plane. First we'll draw the normal rectangle. So in the front view it will look like a straight line, and in the top view it will look like a rectangle. So this width I'll mark. This is 30 mm, so this is the smaller side. So height is 30 and the width is 50 mm, so this is 50. I just draw the light lines. Mark a point, this is 50 mm, make it dark. Same I'll do it on the upper side, or you can directly take a parallel line from that point and make a rectangle. So this is the top view of a rectangle. I'll name this side as A, B, C and D. Now its projection in the front view will be a straight line. So you can draw it on the horizontal plane, or you can draw it above the horizontal plane a bit, as this is just the initial stage. So you can draw it as I have drawn. So this will be A dash, B dash, this point will be C dash and D dash, respective the top view of the rectangle. Now the surface makes an 45 degree inclination with the horizontal plane. So we have to draw an angle of 45 degree here. So I'll mark a point and draw an angle of 45 degree. Now next step, this line, I'll place it on the 45 degree inclination. So you can either directly take the dimension on the scale and mark it, or you can take it on the compass and mark it. So this is A dash, B dash, this is C dash and D dash. So as one end is resting on the horizontal plane, we have drawn this like this. So this is 45 degree angle. Now I'll take the projections downward from the front view to the top view. So this end projections, I've taken this down. Now we'll get the inclination in the top view. So taking this projection here, this will give me the inclination in the top view. So we'll mark the dimensions. Before that, you can draw the rectangle. Now as you can see, the rectangle width has decreased because of the inclination angle. So this I'll mark as A1, B1, C1 and D1. Now further it is given, small side which is at 30 degree inclined to the vertical plane. So this rectangle will draw at an inclination of 30 degree. So I'll mark a point here. I'll draw a 30 degree angle. And its small side is inclined. It is resting on the small side. So this is 30 degree angle. Now I'll take the sides of the rectangle. You can take it on compass or you can directly put it on scale. So this is the width of the smaller side. I'll make it dark. Now draw perpendicular lines from its end. This distance you can take it on scale directly. Draw the perpendicular line. And taking this as the reference line, I'll draw a parallel line from here also, as the angle is 90 degrees. You can take the compass and directly mark the dimensions like this. Then through that point, I'll draw the parallel line. So this is how the rectangle is placed at an angle of 30 degrees. Next, I'll mark the dimensions. This will be A1, B1, C1 and D1. So as we have just placed the rectangle without changing the dimensions, same notations are given. Now I'll take these projections upward towards the front view to see how it is inclined in the front view. So taking this projection upward, now this slant line projection from the front view, we'll take it here. Now the important thing to mark the points properly, this is A dash and this is A1. So this point will be A1 dash. I'll mark this as A1 dash. Now same like this, this is D1, this is D dash, this point intersection will be D1 dash. Same C dash, C1, this will be C1 dash. And final B1, B dash, this point will be B1 dash. Now joining these points will give me the rectangle in the front view with the inclination of 30 degrees. So with this, we are done with our sum. Just I'll mark the arrows how we started. First we drew the rectangle in the top view, then we drew the line. With this line, we placed it here, and with the angle line, we drew the rectangle in the top view. Now this rectangle, I placed it here, took its projections upward, this inclination line projection on the right side, and we drew this. And we are done. Thank you for watching. Do subscribe to my channel. If you have doubts, any queries, let me know in the comment section, or you can connect me on Instagram.